thank God for not in fear again once again. I want to wish Happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there in the audience.
Happy Mother's Day to you.
And the pastor asked us to get up and, you know, say something about our mother or our mom. We said enough for us all.
Amen.
And mom, I do want to thank you for being such a wonderful, great mother that you are. And bringing me in this far and keeping me. And it's good to have a mom that you can go talk to.
Amen.
And when you got something going on in your life, if your mama, give a lot of honor her, you know, respect her, love her, and let her know that you love her.
Amen.
You know, you never know when the time might come that she may be gone. And, well, mom, I love you unconditional, with all my heart, body, and soul. Also, I have a spiritual mom that I love unconditionally. That real said word cannot explain or take the place where I can feel it out. But I love you.
I love you too.
Hallelujah. Today is a day to rejoice. Every day is a day to rejoice and be glad. I was glad they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I know we got something to be praising for, praise the Lord for today. You know, if you think about throughout the week, what all you went through and what you're about to go through, and how God brought you out and kept you, and he kept you in your mind, and gave you limbs and stuff to operate just fine, even though things might not go how you wanted to go, but you're still here by the grace of God. And it's up to us to hold on to God who changes him. We change, but he changed not. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. I want to share with you today Romans 12, verse 2. It says, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may prove which is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Today we are seeing so many people who are professing Christians, yet it seems they never leave the world. This is not God's way, church. God has called his people to this world, but not be in this world. Being in the way of the world. We turn our eyes from the Lord and towards things that direct us attention to the world, which God will not accept. We as Christians have to make a decision to walk in God's way each and every day on a daily basis. In 2 Corinthians 13:5, it tells us, examine ourselves, whether your faith be in Christ Jesus. In other words, we shall try ourselves to see whether our faith be in Christ Jesus. In John 8 and 12, it tells us, Jesus said, I am the light of the world. He who follow me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life, because he is the source of life. Our purpose in this life is to please God. In Titus 2 and 12, it tells us that during the ungodly and worldly lust, we shall live sober, righteous, and godly unto God. This can be only done by the believer making the cross of Christ after his faith, which gives the Holy Spirit latitude to work in our life and bring about the fruit of the Spirit and bring about these grace. We must think spiritual every day to attain it. We must think spiritual every day. Attain it by faith and not by works. It is so important that we look to the cross. This must be renewal of our faith on a daily basis, which is Christ and him crucified, which is Christ has done for us every day. For Satan will not leave us alone. He will do everything in his willpower to get us out of the will of God. But it is our will to be about our Father being on each and every day, basically on a daily basis. I pray that your faith will fail you not. I pray that your faith will rest in Christ Jesus in the wisdom of God and not of man, but in the power of God. May God bless you all. Once again, you cannot have it both ways. Christ or all the world. You must choose. One or the other must go. If you want to be blessed, you want to be happy, you want to have a joyful, peaceful life on this side, trust, obey in God. Lay not to your own understanding. All your way, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. God didn't promise no trouble-free life, but he promised to deliver us by all. And we must maintain faith in Christ and the finished work of the cross. Jesus made a way for us to live. He made a way for us to be obedient. We must trust and obey in the Lord and lean not to our own understanding. Each and every day, church, we have the Word of God here to guide us, to lead us into all truth. We must obey and trust. Lean not to your own understanding. It may not seem right. It may not look right. But what did God say about it? If he said that it shall be, then it shall be. It don't matter how it look, the way it seems. God is the way, the truth, and the life, and no man can come to the Father but by him. Yes, we're going to go through some on this side of the earth, but God, he said he will deliver us out of all. We have to exhibit faith on a daily basis, in spite of what it seems like. I thank God so much for being in my life. I thank God so much. He's not like me. When we mess up, he don't leave us. When we confess our sin, he faithful just to forgive us. Man may not, but God will always. You got to understand, he loves us unconditional. It don't matter how low you go, how wide you may be, how high you go. God's there always to see us through whatever that we're going through. He's always there. And remember, you're not alone. When you walk, he walks right there with you, saying, come unto me. All you are labor and heavy burden. He said, I will give you rest. Rest in the Lord. He already done what we need to do in order to overcome, to be an overcomer. God has already done what we need to do and have. We must continue to exhibit faith in him and him alone. That gives the Holy Spirit latitude to work in us, produce the fruit of the Spirit, which is love, joy, peace, long-suffering. All these above, you have not because you ask not. If you ask amiss, God is not going to honor that. But if you ask in his will, let thy will be done, he will grant that petition. May God bless you all. Love you unconditionally.
Love you too.